Audio included because we went left party. Okay, it's included.
Hello and welcome to the GP2 Season 8 Brazilian Grand Prix. Stez, if you could just check the stream for lag, that would be much appreciated. Okay, so here we are for the Brazilian Grand Prix. You're probably wondering why we're doing one-shot qualifying. We've had a few issues tonight. So we're just going to do some one-shot, the drivers are going to do some one-shot qualifying to decide the grid. In the combox with me tonight is Stez1984. He commentated in Australia, but unfortunately couldn't commentate for the rest of the season. He's standing in for Birdie Steel for Words. Stez, how are you?
I'm well, thanks, mate. How are you?
I am good. So we've had a few issues tonight, but what do you think? You know, how do you think the race is going to go?
Well, we'll have to see what weather's like. We all know about this track. It can go from lovely and bright to rain in certain areas very, very quickly. So let's hope it'll go well. I want to see good racing, clean racing, hopefully a full lobby tonight. So yeah, it's gonna be good.
Okay, thank you. So currently, Real Shots is leading the lap. So obviously, in one shot qualifying, you know, you can change positions very quickly. We've got T Quick Show in third. At the moment, we've got Smack Diesel leading the pack. Stez, I'll just say it again. You could try and just check the stream for any lag issues. I'm sure it's fine
it's
at the moment.
Cool. It's looking fine.
It's fine at the moment, but if you could just keep an eye on that for me. Smack Diesel. They're looking very quick on his lap now in pole position. We don't really know what times they're setting right now because we're not in the garage. We can't see. So we're just going by the position. So Smack Diesel coming out the final corner. For the title, actually, Maranzano, the gap currently between Maranzano and Ninjas, the title could be decided here in Brazil. Smack Diesel and Ninjas before this Grand Prix are actually separated by 40 points.
That's the end.
So, yeah.
Let me go through the grid.
Yes, if you can. I'm trying to take a screenshot, but it is not working.
Okay, so the grid. Let's do top 10 for today. It's Smack Diesel on pole with Maranzano in second. All-rounder in third with Real Shots in fourth. Expired Ninjas in 5th.
We've got
and
one viewer.
Teak Quickshare in 6th. ILR Aero in 7th. Urban Unicorn in 8th. The Fredster in 9th. And Dennis BKK in 10th. Rounding out the top 10 for Brazil.
Okay, Melanie's just sent me a message saying, wow. So, okay, we're now going through the loading screens. Stez, predictions. Can Ninjas win the championship here in Brazil?
Oh, well, taking a look at it, top two look promising. But let's just hope. I want to see no first corner calamities. I want to see a championship being crowned here in Brazil.
Okay. Thank you for that. Okay, so remember, not get off the start line, just reverse. That's what the drivers told us to do. Safety car like in Mexico. Apparently it's lagging a bit, so I don't know what's going on there.
I'm checking, don't worry.
Okay, that was a bit retarded there. Oh, okay.
This is what we do, everybody. Wrong format. There we go.
Two viewers. Stez, I don't know what's going on here. Okay, it's live again, apparently. Okay, there's been a crash down at turn one. I don't know there because obviously it wasn't seen and now it isn't working. Great then. Here we go. Smack Diesel now in first place. Stez, we've got two viewers and it is a virtual safety car. Virtual safety car. That's not us. I think that might may have been Melanie going slowly out of cover de sol. We've got two viewers. The other viewer, other than Stairs, put in the chat who you are. Was here we are in Brazil. So, yeah. It's going to be very interesting.
These guys on formation lap one right there,
no, they're on lap one stairs. They're on virtual safety car right now.
Virtual safety car. Should be ending in any second.
Okay, Stairs, if you just like to take, I'm currently spectating like the front of the pack right now. If you could just tell me who, like, if you're spectating anyone, like the battles that's going on. Okay, so it's now a battle going on for first place. We've got got all round up the inside of Smack Dizzle there, and there's been some sort of issue. Apparently it's still virtual safety car, and it's go. On the back of Curva de Sol now. We've got Maranzano running outside of Smack Dizzle. Smack Dizzle, he's looking very, very strong here, but now we're going to go into broadcast mode to have a better view now. We've got the Ferrari around the outside. Smack Dizzle now on the inside of the Red Bull, and he's gone onto the grass, and that's going to not have good traction for him. Going to have to spectate all round RX, who's currently in third place. There's been a crash at the back. I'm sure I just saw a crash at the back of the field there. What's happened down there, down at turn? I don't know what corner that was. Jonna now in 15th, and he's defending hard. Yeah. He's defending hard on Typhon there. Defending hard, quite aggressively there, I must admit. I don't know who's had the collision. Melanie down in 17th, and Cardonal in 18th. Not a good start for the two Mercedes drivers. There's a battle going on here for second place. Very spaced out. Stairs, how's the stream looking? Is it good?
Looking good.
Okay, so now we've got all-rounder X now getting under pressure now by Smack Dizzle, and now in his McLaren. Up the inside goes the McManna, an all-rounder span. He's out of the race. All-rounder out of the Grand Prix there, and there's been a Williams going flying off down there into the centre S's, and all-rounder X down into 16th place. That is disappointing for the Red Bull driver. Just the McManna just completely destroyed what was straight up the inside there, and actually kind of like hit. I don't know what really happened there, but he kind of hit all-rounder, and all-rounder got into a spin. But also, I haven't really spoke about this, but going into this Grand Prix, X-Bike Ninjas and Maranzano, that message. Maranzano were, Stairs has just gone for a moment. Before this Grand Prix, X-Bike Ninjas and Maranzano were spaced out by 40 points, and for the championship to go to Abu Dhabi, Maranzano must win the Grand Prix. He's currently leading it, and X-Bike Ninjas must finish fifth or below. But anyway, we've got the Ferrari now. We've got all-rounder X defending. No, I think he got past Fresta there with the DRS activated. So that is a good overtaking move there from Fresta. But massive corner cut there, and Smack's in the wall. Smack's in the wall. He's out of the race. He's lost his front wing. He's hit the polystyrene. He's lost his front wing, and he's out of the Grand Prix, spinning it on the entry to Curva de Sol, and he's out of the race. Smack Dizzle letting through his teammate there, and that is disappointing for the Dutchman. He's had a very, very hard night tonight with connecting to the session and so forth, but that is disappointing. Typhon has been able to get through on Jonna, but now there's a battle going on for 10th place between the two Williams drivers, Jose Bocadillo, and ILR Aero, and Typhon trying to get into the action there, but we're going to move away from this battle and move on to T Quickshare, someone who could definitely be in the contention for promotion for next season, showing his pace and his obviously history with the Noob Journey. But X-Bike Ninjas now on the back of Urban Unicorn. Urban Unicorn having a very good Grand Prix, currently in fourth place. Going to move to broadcast mode just to show all the drivers now coming through into the center S's. And the Toro Rosso of X-Bike Ninjas gets past Urban Unicorn. That is definitely what he needed for the quest for his World Championship. But now the mana is going to get involved of X-Bike Rampage. Ran the outside now, Curva de Sol. And there's all the drivers off the track. There's a Williams off there. There's a Williams off, but. And Aero retired from the Grand Prix there. But now there's... Oh! And Rampage is in the wall! Rampage in the wall there. That's not good. Typhon Killer now going to go up the inside of the manor. And Rampage, has he lost his front... Yeah. I think he's got some damage there. The car wasn't turning. So, God, this is very, very tense here in Brazil. And, that is disappointing. Calavera in 11th. And there's been a spin out. The Red Bull. Why am I spectating him? Typhoon Killer is out of the race. Okay, this is very, very action-packed first few laps of the Brazilian Grand Prix, but Maranzano is absolutely controlling the front of the field. First is Maranzano, second is Real Shots, and he's got some company here from the Fredster. So let's just have a look at this. This is for second place. Fredster lagging slightly. He's just keeping behind the German. A Real Shot slowing very slowly, and he's defending from Fredster very aggressively, it looks like, from the rear view. We've got two viewers now. Yeah, just comment if you're watching. Just comment who you are. So the Fredster now behind Real Shots. I'm just going to skip now back here. So there's no battles going on with X-Bar Ninjas, Urban Unicorn. This is quite spaced out for a GP2 session, to be fair. But now we've got some battles going on as Typhoon Killer left the session. José Bocadillo and expired Rampage now in a battle, the Spanish driver of Posse. Expired Rampage in 8th now. He's going to try and go for the overtake, I think. He's going to have the DRS. Yeah, he's got the DRS activated on the Spanish driver. And now he's going to go. Is he going to go up the inside? No, he's not. He's going to try and keep it for the next section. He actually had a very decent run. I don't think it's going to be enough. So we're going to move away from that. Oh, Rampage then. What's going to happen here? So Rampage. Oh, well, that was lag. I was getting a bit of hype there. But Rampage here, currently behind Jose, I think. No, Caleb. Yeah, Jose. Sorry about that. Trying now for 6th place. Doing much better than he was at this point in Mexico last week. He was doing very good in Mexico. He wasn't doing very good in Mexico. He was lying down in 12th or 11th, I think, at this point. He wasn't having a good race. But he's now battling for 6th place. Very interesting here in Brazil. Calavera lagging slightly. Melanie then in 9th. Jona in the Red Bull in 10th place. 11th is Expired Ninjas. Expired Ninjas! Okay, something happened to Expired Ninjas. This is not good for his World Championship. Remember, he has to finish 5th or lower. Higher than 5th to win the championship if Maranzano is in the... if the race finishes like this. So, some people are in the pit lane as well. All round up in 13th. Comment if you're watching. So, it's quite boring at this part of the track. Smack Dizzle. Very disappointing. But Urban Unicorn leads the Grand Prix of Brazil. But there's going to be a battle going on now between Expired Rampage and Jose. Now into these sections. Don't even know the names. I only know Curva de Sol, but doesn't really matter as such, because this is going to be an incredible battle when it commences. But it looks like Rampage is kind of struggling for the grip out of corners. And he's into the pit lane. Cuts a little bit of the pit lane there. He's going very slow into the pit lane, so he doesn't get a drive-through penalty. So we're going to move away from him. Jonna's up the inside. Jonna up the inside of Melanie. Melanie's going to try and get the cut back. Jonna very aggressive, pushing Melanie here at Curva de Sol. And Melanie, oh, okay, very aggressive driving there from Jonna. And Melanie down into 5th place. So and he's jumped Maranzano. If Maranzano wants to get this championship, he needs to hurry up. He's looking very quick on the hard tyres as well. He's going for longest stint for the second stop, so it's going to be very interesting. A lot of battles going on. Sorry, not a lot of battles going on right now. Just people spread out trying to catch. Oh, and Melanie's made a mistake. And oh, that was a nice, easy overtake there for Maranzano. So Maranzano now up into fifth. Ninja's currently in eighth, but he's now behind Fredster. Good job, I spectated him. But into the broadcast mode now. Behind the manor. Rani outside goes Ninjas. Is he going to try and go for the other thing? No, he's not. He needs to do this, though. He needs to try and get as many positions as he can to be crowned world champion here today. And Fredster's breaking the slipstream, so I don't think there's going to be much of a battle here. Melanie is in fifth. Maranzano up into fourth, and he's now going to try and get to Jonna. Jonna definitely shown in this race previously, in the last few laps. He's a very aggressive driver, and he definitely wants... he definitely likes to defend his position quite hard, so we'll be looking to see what he can do. So Rudster's in 16th, Smack in 15th, Urban in 14th, Cardinal in 13th, Dennis VKK in 12th, Allrounder in 11th. Disappointing for him. Disappointing for Rampage as well. He's only in 10th. Tick Quickshare in 9th, Real Shots in 8th place. This is very spread out, but quite close though to Real Shots. He's expired. Ninja 6th is the Fredster. 5th is Melanie. And then there's a battle just as we go on to 3rd and 4th now. No, 4th and 5th. Sorry, we've got Maranzano around the outside. No, 3rd and 4th actually, yeah. Maranzano, brilliant overtaking move against the very aggressive Spaniard. And he goes up into 3rd place. Jonello back into the slipstream. He's going to try and go for a late dive bomb move up into the next corner. No, he's not. He's going to try and just stay behind him. Try and get the slipstream. Just try and keep behind him for the long journey from the last corner to the first. Maranzano definitely having the race of his life here. But there's a battle going on here between the two Spaniards of Calavera and Jose Bocadillo. So this is going to be a very interesting to see the two Spanish drivers battling. We've got three Spanish drivers in the league now. Jose Bocadillo, Calavera and Jonna. Very good. Calavera obviously showed us his intermediate skills as when everyone was on wet, he actually finished fifth and he went the whole race, the whole, like, when it was wet on intermediates. But he's not going to go. Jose's not going to go for a dive bomb. And he's hit the grass. He's hit the grass and he's made a mistake, and that is really going to help Calavera here. And Jose Bocadillo messes up his chances of taking the lead of the Brazilian Grand Prix. Okay, Maranzano then. That's definitely going to help Maranzano catch up to the Spaniard. I'm sure he's waiting for them to pit. Melanie then. It's a little battle going on, I think, here. Yep. Ninjas and for Fredster. This is for all for fifth. Four-way battle. Melanie, Fredster, Ninjas and Real Shots. Very laggy. So yeah, very interesting. Very interesting. Here in Brazil, it's a very good track as well for battles, because there's a lot. The track is very wide as well, so this is why we're having a lot of good battles, I think. But here we go. We've got expired Ninjas just trying to get on the back of the Fredster. But I think, I don't know if this is lag from me or lag from the drivers. But yeah, Real Shots then in seventh. Just got past Ninjas. Is he going to try and go for the overtake on the Fredster? As Melanie's in the pit lane, I think. Melanie? Yeah, Melanie in the pit lane. We're going to have to jump back to Real Shots. It's been... Oh! Real Shots now. Going to try and go on the back of Fredster. Made a little mistake at the centre S's. On the... Out of the Cover de Sol. And onto the next. And he's done it with DRS. Brilliant overtake move. Up to fourth goes Real Shots. First is Calavera. showing his worth here in Brazil. He's actually started on the hards here. So that's a very interesting strategy call from him. Maranzano in second. Definitely needs to hurry up if he wants to get his title back on board. Third is Jana, 2014. Fourth is Real Shots. Fifth is the Fredster. And sixth is Ninjas. That is the top six. Ninjas at the moment will not win the championship here in Brazil. They'll have to wait till the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. So if drivers want to help Maranzano, they need to hurry up. So yeah, here we are in Brazil, lap 13 out of 36 for X-Bar Ninjas, moving on to lap 40 now. He's in the slipstream of the Fredster. Fredster's going to move very aggressively onto the inside line. He's going to actually kind of cause Ninjas to go off a little bit wide there. That was aggressive but fair defending from the Fredster. Very good. Here in Brazil, showing a lot of talent in the session. But no, X-Bar Ninjas is definitely showing he is championship material. Currently, he would win the championship, so good on him. No, he wouldn't. No. Yes, he would. No. I will calculate it, guys, while I'm commentating for you. I will calculate it, and I will confirm at the end of the Grand Prix who has won this, who has got the championship. But let's not think about lap 36. Let's think about moving on to lap 15 now. X-Bar Ninjas, a little bit of a mistake coming out of the final corner. Hun Xiao. And now on to the straight. He's going to try and go in the slipstream again on the Fredster. Fredster, very good. He's shown this season he's very good at overtaking and actually defending. He's definitely shown that a lot this season. But now he's on the back of the... Ninja's on the back of the Fredster. Fredster keeping to the inside line. Very good defensive skills here from the Mana driver. And he's made a mistake. No, he hasn't. That's lag. Ninja's now on the back of the Fredster. Going to try and go for a little overtake now. Going to have to change the view. He's got all rounder on the outside. All rounder up the inside, and Jonna has left the session. That's not good. That's not good for him. But X-Bar Ninjas in sixth. Jonna has joined, so be able to get back into the racing. Okay, let's spectate all rounder now, because he's definitely... So yeah, Ninjas at the moment would not win the World Championship. He has to finish lower than fifth. Yeah, calculated. So he has to finish lower than fifth, and with Maranzano winning, for Maranzano to have a chance of the championship in Abu Dhabi. But all round up. Up this side, but he's defending from Fredster, and there's been a collision. That's going to help Ninjas. That's really going to help Ninjas. It's been a very weird collision down into turn one. Fredster and all rounder. Very, don't know the word really. Very, weird, but Fredster gives the position back onto all-rounder, so that is decent, and Fredster has retired from the Brazilian Grand Prix, so that's not very good for him, because now he's not going to get any points, but there's a Mana off the track. It's Fredster's AI. Oh. Very sorry. So yeah, Fredster out of the Brazilian Grand Prix. Not good. And for him, let's just have a look how many drivers we have left racing. I think we've got 15 drivers left. Calavera leading the Grand Prix now. Got a battle for first place between Calavera and Maranzano. I don't think this is really going to start much at the moment. We're going to still keep an eye on it. Calavera still to pit in this Grand Prix. Yeah, not much is going to happen there. Third is Real Shots. Fourth is X-Bar Ninjas, definitely in his quest now for the World Championship. X-Bar Rampage in fifth, definitely shown that, he's doing brilliantly. Seventh is Yose. Eighth is Urban. We're going to actually keep an eye on this battle now, because I think there's going to be some DRS action. DRS activated, for Urban Unicorn. That's it. Cadillon in 7th. Urban Unicorn in 8th. 9th is Team Quickshare. 10th is Smack Dizzle. 11th is Meloni, the Finnish driver. 12th is Jonna. 13th is Cardano. 14th is Dennis. And 15th is the Rusters, who actually just came in for a pit stop. So we've missed the McLaren guys at work. Calavera, though, he's defending from Maranzano. And Maranzano looking very quick behind the Spaniard now. Trying his best to try and get past him. Oh, just paused it. So here we are then. Sorry about that pausing, guys. Here we are, Maranzano now in second place. So this is very spaced out right now. It's very spaced out grid right now. We're just waiting. I think all the drivers are just sitting tight, waiting for the pit stops. Maranzano definitely showing his pace over Calavera right now, but he's... It's not good, because there's no battles. Looks like Spider Rampage is slowly catching up to Ninjas. But he's got All-Rounder for company, so that'd be interesting. And I'll say, and Urban in a bit of a battle now for 7th. Let's have a look at this, see if anything is going to commence down into the centre S's. Could it? It's a very slow run from when the DRS is actually activated to the first corner, but Urban's gone for it up the inside. Urban's gone for it. He's going to try and go for the cutback. Jose there, bit of a mistake, but is it going to happen into 5th? So, someone speed, expired Ninja speed, but now Urban Unicorn up the inside of Rosset. Rosset's going to try and go around the outside. Oh, off the track, and Urban has got the overtake done. Rosset taking too much speed, and that is definitely going to regret that later in the Grand Prix. Okay, 13th is Cardar now. 14th, Dennis. 15th, Rudsters. So at the moment, the leader, Maranzano. So Calavera. So yeah, oh, it's a Ferrari 1-2, but yeah, Calavera, migrating host. I don't know who the host is. So we've now got Jose Bocadillo now on the back of Urban Unicorn. He's going to go into the slipstream now. He's going to dive, try and go around the outside of the Haas. Is he going to try and do it? He's going to try and go on the inside now. He's doing a Max Verstappen move. It's going to work. He's trying to go around the outside. He's got the Force India of T Quickshare now interested in the battle. And he's picked them both off. Rudsters has joined the session back. So I think the host might have been Rudsters. But T Quickshare there. Brilliant overtaking move up into 5th. And he's got 2 places there. And there's been a bit of a collision. What's that? So Smack Dizzle, I don't know who crashed then, but Calavera onto a set of mediums now, so he's looking to go quite far in this Grand Prix, maybe go on to another set of maybe softs to end the Grand Prix. That would be a good strategy for him, as everyone will probably be on the hearts near the end of the Grand Prix. But Urban Unicorn now on the back of Jose Bocadillo, and this battle has been got a lot of coverage as Jose in this Grand Prix. I gotta give it to him. He's had a lot of coverage from me, so if this was a real life, Williams would have a lot of sponsor money coming their way. Oh, and there's a Red Bull. Who's that? All-Rounder X. All-Rounder X, is there some sort of issue? He's got a puncher. He's had a puncher. Now Smack Dizzle's gonna get held up by him. So All-Rounder puncher there. On a set of hards, what tyre is he now going to go on? Is he going to go on a set of hards to the end, or is it going to be mediums? It's going to be hards. This could be to the end of the Grand Prix. Good decision there from the Red Bull strategy team. Obviously from All-Rounder, but Melanie in 12th then. Mac Diz was actually being jumped by Melanie. This ain't good for him. Okay, so Maranzano leads the Grand Prix. Ninja's currently in ninth. Just, I think he's just waiting for everyone to pit around him. But Calavera definitely doing a good job here in Brazil. On the back of Jose, he's currently trying to keep up with Urban Unicorn. But Calavera definitely showing that he's got the pace. And the he's made those tyres. I think he pit in on lap 18 or something like that. So he made the hards go very late into this Grand Prix. So it's very good. Very good from him. Jose looks like to be catching up to Urban very quickly. But Urban's going to try and break the slipstream down into the centre S's. Jose going to stay behind him. Good decision from the Spaniard. But he's going to try and still get the better line. So let's see now. He's got the DRS on Urban Unicorn. He's going to try and go for the overtake. Is he going to do it at Deseta de Lago? And he's spun! He's out! He's spun out of the race. Fifth goes Calavera. Seventh. No, Woodster's unlaps himself there. But John, the two Spaniards now going to be battling for sixth place. And oh, John has been taken out! Jose, joining back onto the track, has been swiped by his fellow countryman. Jose, that is... okay, that's disappointing. All rounder though up the inside. Jonna letting him through. That is big. Okay, that is big news at the Brazilian Grand Prix. Jonna. There's going to be a lot of arguments, I think, in the party tonight. But Maranzano going for a new win. He's rejoined in second, so definitely on his quest for the win is Maranzano. But this is going to be an interesting battle now. Urban Unicorn. Shown him a lot in this Grand Prix, but let's see now. Calavera, he's definitely showing the pace for a podium. You know, he finished fifth in Mexico. He pitted on intermediates. He went so far into the wet stint. He went all the way. When everyone went on wets, he stayed out. When wets was the better tyre, he was able to use those intermediates and really make them work in the conditions. But I'm just going to invite all rounder back if I can. Yeah. Okay, so Calavera's had a much better exit than Urban Unicorn, but Urban Unicorn's going to defend hard against the Spaniard, and now he's going to really, really need to defend hard. And there's been a crash! Urban Unicorn and Calavera. And Calavera's retired from the Grand Prix. He's out. Yeah, you can see that. You can see that there. You can see that. That is disappointing. Calavera out of the race in Brazil. That could cause safety car. I think he may have had some rear suspension damage there on his car. But that is not what he needed here in Brazil today. That is disappointing. Urban Unicorn may have lagged or something like that. I think that may have been the issue. That is disappointing. Jose Bocadillo in 10th. Cardon out in 11th. All-rounder left the session. So Dennis is going to overtake him there. Woodster's in 15th. So, this is been a very interesting Grand Prix. And now there's no battles. But there could be a battle now between Expired Ninjas and Expired Rampage. This could be Ninja's day. Could be the day for Ninja's that he wins the World Championship here in Brazil. He's shown a lot of consistency this season, but there's now going to be a three-way battle between John at Smack Dizzle and I think that is Melanie. Melanie, one of my favourite drivers, I've got to admit. But Jonna in his Red Bull going to try and defend on Smack Dizzle here. Smack Dizzle in the slipstream, but is he going to try and go for the overtake? Calaveras just sent me a message, but we'll have to read that. And Spack Dizzle, he has to give the position back. Spack Dizzle just cut across the corner, and he's given the position back. Good sportsmanship there from Smack Dizzle, but now he's got Melanie all over the back of him. We need to jump to this. Melanie up the inside at the seat of the Lago, and brilliant. He defends off Smack Dizzle now. Can Smack Dizzle go up the inside? Is Smack Dizzle going to try it? No, he's not. Melanie in eighth place. Nice overtaking move there. He's doing very good at defending this position. Hopefully ready for next season is Melanie. Staying in the GP2 division. So could be an underdog. But no, he's defended quite aggressively there on the insider. But Smack's got the overtake done. Smack back up to eighth. But could Melanie get him back? But could Smack get Jonna back? That is the real question here in Interlagos. Jose Bocadillo on the back of Melanie as well. So there could be two separate battles. But no, the Red Bull goes into the pit lane. Jonna into the pit lane. Jose Bocadillo now. Up the inside of Melanie. This could be the overtake that he needs. No, he actually backs out of it. So didn't trust Melanie there. But Melanie, a little bit bad on the brakes. Jose using that curve for best exit. But Jose now. DRS onto Melanie 88. Is he going to try to go around the outside? Is Jose? Yes, he is. And Melanie hits off his back wheel. Melanie hits off his back wheel there. But brilliant overtaking move from Jose. Melanie hitting off the back of the Spaniard. Up into eighth goes Jose. Seventh is Smack Dizzle. So this is very, very interesting scenes here. Expired Ninjas definitely having the race of his life here. He needs to, for Manzano to actually still be with a chance of the championship in Abu Dhabi. Expired Ninjas would have had to finish low out them fifth, so this is not looking good for Maranzano right now. But he is more than likely going to be confirmed to be into the F1 division next season. So hopefully he can show some good pace in there. But now we've got the two expired guys coming into some sort of battle now. I just need to put it on pause because I just need to check something right now. Okay. So, yeah, here we go in Brazil. This is very interesting. We've got Ninjas in fourth, Expired Rampage in third right now. So this is very interesting here in Brazil. This is very surprising as well, because Expired Rampage has, for the past like 6-7 races, always been at the bottom end of the top 10, but now he's really doing good. He's into podium position, but could that be stolen by Expired Ninjas? Here we go then. He's letting him through. Expired Rampage has let Expired Ninjas through. That is cheeky there from the two mates. Okay then, so let's see if there's any battles going on. So we've got T-Quickshare. No, not in a battle. Urban Unicorn close behind though. Boss say no. Getting caught a little bit by Melanie. Right. Let's watch this battle commence. Dennis and John out. 8 laps to go now of the Brazilian Grand Prix. It's for the final point between Dennis and Jonna. Cardonal in 12th, and 13th is the Rudsters. So, it's not been the day. It's not been a good day for the Rudsters. He's had a lot of bad luck here in Brazil. But it is a 1-2 for Ferrari at this moment in time. Ferrari would be the Constructors World Champions of Season 8. Their first STB Constructors Championship. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's a battle commencing now between T-Quickshare and the Manor of the Fredster now. Here we go. No. No. Sorry, my mistake. Expired Rampage. There's now a battle going on between the two of them. Let's see if Expired Rampage can keep his position, because fourth, for how his season has gone, it's gone very badly, to say the least. He's had a very hard season. A lot of things haven't really gone his way. And it's definitely a time in Abu Dhabi to really think about what he can do next season to make it a better season for himself, because he's definitely in with a chance of getting a good result next season in the championship. But we've now got Expired Rampage defending from the Fredster. No, from T-Quickshare, sorry. My mistake. T-Quickshare now going to try and go around the outside. He's done it. He's done it. You can see it on the broadcast mode there. He has done it. Brilliant. So, Expired Rampage in the slipstream. Well, he was, but now he's out of the slipstream, and he isn't doing as well now. You know, he was showing some decent pace early in the Grand Prix, but not showing it now. Smack Dizzle in seventh. Not had a good Grand Prix either. Jose Bocadillo now in eighth. Ninth is Meloni. Very, very spaced out for a GP2 race. This is very, very spaced out. Very surprising here in Brazil. Cardinal in 12th, and the Roadsters still in 13th. Not had a good season, and he's into the pit lane. The Roadsters dives into the pit lane, and I think he could be going up. This could be the only time he's actually shown in this race, so this is good publicity for the Roadsters. Here we go. He's going to go into the pit lane now, and he goes on to a set of softs to the end of the Grand Prix. I think he's just doing some warm-up laps now, get himself warmed up for next season's Brazilian Grand Prix. Maranzano then leads the Grand Prix in Brazil. He's had a very decent Grand Prix, but I don't think it's going to be enough for the World Championship. T-Quickshare though could make the gap that he loses to a little bit less. And yes, if Expired Ninjas does finish fifth in this Grand Prix and Maranzano wins, the championship does go to Abu Dhabi, as Maranzano's had more wins than Ninjas. I think. I'm pretty sure. So, he would have had more wins than Expired. So, because Expired has had a lot of podiums, but he hasn't had many wins this season, which is quite disappointing for him. But, yeah. Okay, then. Here we go. And the Roadsters has left. The Roadsters, disappointing for him. But we're going to spectate Ninjas now, who's going to fight for his position here. But, okay, that was a bit of a hype moment there. He's not going to battle for his position here in Brazil. Fifth is Rampage, Expired Rampage here. Obviously, he's not going to, don't think, actually overtake Ninjas. Who two of them being mates. So, that was very cheeky that Rampage only got to actually let Ninjas through. That was quite interesting. But the Ferrari guys, Mauricio Riffabene, definitely going to be happy with these two drivers this evening. Well, this morning in the actual game, but this evening, obviously, in the racing. So Ferrari, the way it stands at the moment, will be Constructors Champions. And at the moment, as it stands, Expired Ninjas will be crowned the Season 8 World Champion of the GP2 Division. Fusion, TOSX Fusion, obviously, was crowned GP1, well, F1 Division Champion at the Japanese Grand Prix. So very much earlier than GP2. Expired Rampage then in fifth, definitely having a better Grand Prix than he did last time out in Mexico, as he was flopping at the back end of the top 10. He's had a lot more coverage this Grand Prix, so Manor will be happy. Around lap 33 now, not much is happening here in Brazil. But it has been a battle. It's been a good race in terms of battles and in terms of good battles, as I said, and also just everything that's gone on. You know, there's been a lot of strategy involved in this Grand Prix, which just been very interesting to see. Calavera, I was just thinking, where's Calavera, but just realised he's not in the Grand Prix anymore, which is really disappointing because he was looking on a very good strategy. You know, started on hards, went quite long into the Grand Prix. It just wasn't his day. It's just not his day. Rampage then. Slowly but surely, a little bit catching to Expired Ninjas every sector, I believe, but it's not enough right now to help Maranzano in his quest for the World Championship. Now, even if Ninjas does finish fifth, there is a very low chance even that. Even if that does happen, that Maranzano will be crowned world champion, because due to, you know, 25 points, it'll be a 25 point gap. You know, Maranzano has to win, Ninjas no points. So it'll be very good to see Ninjas finish in fifth, but very low chance of it happening. Maranzano enters his penultimate, he's on his penultimate lap. Quickshare, which is opening his penultimate lap of the Grand Prix. Not many battles going on now, it's just very spaced out, just waiting for the race to end now. Drivers, but oh, there's a battle now. I was proved wrong. Here we go. Smack Diesel now on the back. And he's just let through by Urban. That's what it looked like to me, but probably because the DRS was having more pace. Smack Diesel then in sixth. They definitely helped Maranzano this evening, but no fault of his own. Deserved a very bad run here tonight. Expired Ninjas in fourth. T-Quickshare in third. This is not what he needs. You know, it's been a very, very disappointing Grand Prix for many drivers in this race. Maranzano is so unlucky. You know, he had a very, very bad run of it in Mexico. Having a drive-through penalty that definitely destroyed his championship chances, and it's not the season at the moment that he wants. You know, he wanted this championship. I did speak to him a few weeks ago actually, and he was ready for the challenge, and Mexico just kind of destroyed that. But Smack Diesel now on the back of Expired Rampage is really going to try and help his cause for fifth place. But Expired Rampage there, not close enough. But Expired Rampage here, he's gonna have an Urban Unicorn all over the back of him now, and he's actually gonna have the Rudsters now into the battle now. So that's interesting. Smack Diesel has completely gone off, but Rampage now, Rudsters, he's gonna get in the battle. Rudsters unlapping himself. This is lovely for him, and he's yeah, Rampage lost the position to Urban Unicorn, so there you go. But let's spectate Maranzano now, just in time, and Maranzano takes the lead, takes the win at the Brazilian Grand Prix, but that is not going to be enough. We don't think. Expired Ninjas, what an incredible season for the Toro Rosso team. A lot of podiums this season. An amazing performance here in Brazil by Expired Ninjas. But Expired Ninjas has had a brilliant run of it, and he is crowned the Season 8 World Champion of the world. He is World Champion. And an incredible season by Expired Ninjas. He has shown a lot of drivers. He's proved a lot of drivers wrong from pre-season testing. As Cardinal has left the session, but that is disappointing, as Jonna has got a penalty. Jonna's got a puncher, sorry. But let's just, you know, it's not been the season that Maranzano has wanted. It's not Maranzano. A lot of things have gone wrong for him. A lot of things have gone wrong. And we're now actually going to invite him. Well, we're going to invite Teak Quickshare first for a quick interview. So we're now going to do the podium interviews. So let's just get Teak into the party. So yeah, that is a very interesting Grand Prix there. A lot of things, interesting things happened at Interlagos. A lot of crashes, a lot of battles. But we now have Teak Quickshare in the party. Teak, if you could just include your audio. I'm just going to give you a quick interview. Just tell me when you've included it. Yeah, tick the box. Is the box ticked at the top, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Hello, Teak. A good podium today. How do you feel the race went for you?
Well, I wasn't completely on it from the start because of, like, the restart, so I wasn't focused, and I ended up being, like, 11th out of the first corner, I think. So I'm very happy to be able to come onto the podium after a very difficult start.
Okay. We're also aware that you could be getting promoted up to the F1 division. Can you give us more information? Can you give our viewers more information about that?
Yeah, well, I'm sort of thinking about it, but it requires a lot of practice for me to be able to compete at that level, so I'm not entirely sure that I'll make the jump, but it's still an opportunity, I think.
Okay, thank you. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, thank you, and a good podium, Teak.
Thank you.
And yeah, thank you. Okay then, so that was Teak in the party there. So a very interesting words there. He thinks it's a good opportunity, but we'll see next season in Australia whether he has made the jump to the F1 division. Real shots then. Real shots, you like to include your audio.
I ticked the box.
Good, you ticked the box, unlike Mexico. Okay, yeah. Real shots. You had a lot, well, there's a lot of issues in that Grand Prix. There's a lot of crashes, a lot of good battles, however.